Hi, I'm Tim Berglund with Confluent. There are two kinds of code in the world. There's code that provides measurable, demonstrable value to the specific people using the software you're writing, and there's everything else. In the everything else category, you have really important things like programming languages, build tools, databases, application frameworks, front-end frameworks, blockchain, meme coins, AI chatbots, and certainly integration code. And you know, integration always seems so simple. You get the thing from over there and you put it into Kafka. You take the thing from Kafka and you put it into that system over there. But you know it's never really that easy. And besides, reading from a database or writing into S3 is a great example of undifferentiated code, to put it politely. It's code that you shouldn't be writing. Like, it might seem like a value-added part of your application, but like my favorite software architect, Admiral Akbar, would say, it's a trap.
It's a trap.
The bottomless pit of edge cases and infrastructure development that all distract you from your mission of building useful things for your actual users. This is why Kafka Connect exists. It's the de facto standard for streaming data integration, built in as a part of open source Apache Kafka. It provides all the runtime infrastructure you need to run always-on streaming data integration jobs. But more importantly, it has an ecosystem of pre-built connectors. A quick GitHub search will show you literally a few thousand separate repos associated with individual Kafka Connect connectors that you will never have to write yourself. Of course, you know as well as I do that not all of those repos are, expertly maintained. That's why Confluent has a pre-vetted, validated ecosystem of more than 120 connectors covering the vast majority of integration inputs and outputs that you're likely to encounter in your actual life. At the time of this recording, 80 of those are also available in fully managed form in Confluent Cloud. You want to build powerful data integration pipelines, but avoid spending your time writing code that doesn't directly serve your users? This is how you do it. And 120 unique data integrations is a lot, but what if the one you need still isn't there? You know, like you have that one weird file format that's kind of CSV, but not quite, and the CSV reader doesn't get it, or a fork of Parquet that some previous architect thought was a good idea, and now you have to live with it, or some mainframe code with weird timeouts and an even weirder character encoding. I get it. Sometimes, despite all my and Admiral Akbar's warnings, you really do have to write your own connector. And when you do, Connect makes it pretty friendly. You'll just handle the pain in the neck interface integration code, and you get to ignore all the other infrastructure details that normally come up in a project like this. Those are already baked into the framework. And you can even run that custom connector in Confluent Cloud with our bring your own connector support. Paraphrasing the poem, no code is an island. You're going to need to connect to other systems. Don't build all this stuff yourself. And when you're picking tools, go where the community is. Go where there is a burgeoning ecosystem of proven connectors and a great way to run them in the cloud. You want to learn more? You can always check out developer.confluent.io or click the link in the description. And hey, subscribe to this channel if you want to, or don't. I think the right videos are probably going to find you regardless.